Hi everyone, this is Ajit from Catalyst class. So today I'm going to talk about the rational and irrational number, okay? So I'm going to create the two videos, okay? One for the rational number and second for the irrational number. And after that, I will create one more videos that will for the each chapter assignment, okay? So I have mentioned here the complete the number system, okay? So this is the real number. It under this each and every number come, okay? It can be plus 1 to minus okay, plus 1 to minus 1, 0, okay, or 2 by 3 fractional number kind of things, okay? Or we can say the irrational number root 3, root 6, and root underscore 5 or something like that, okay? So each and everything will come under the real number, okay? So this is the bigger picture, okay, that we can say this is the complete whole set, in this complete number exist, okay. So from this real number we divide it, okay, like the one is the rational number and other is the irrational number, okay. So from the real number, the number system is split in two parts, okay, if you go in depth, okay. So from the real number, one part is rational number and other part is irrational number. So rational number is like any of the integer number, okay, that is from the minus to plus, okay, including zero, okay, or some fractional number. This is called the completely rational number. Now we will come to the irrational number, okay, and here we will go in depth, but just insert I will give the idea. The second part is irrational number, like the underscore 7, underscore 3, that's not the perfect square kind of number. So those number are underscore 7, underscore 3, such kind of number will come into the irrational number, okay. Now we will see the rational number again divided, okay, into two parts. One is the integer and other is the non-integer integral relation, okay. So integer is just like the minus, okay, x to plus x including 0, okay. Non-integral is the fractional kind of number. It can be plus or minus, right. The second thing is, again, the integer is divided with the negative integer, 0 and positive integer. So integer we are seeing here the minus 2 plus, okay. If I take the number system, okay, here is the 0, here this side is the negative, this side is the positive, okay. So in the integer part, we consider the all number positive and negative including 0. So now integer is divided into three parts. One is the negative integer, so we know that, okay, so minus 2, minus 3, okay, these are the negative number, then 0, okay, and other third one is the positive number. So positive number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, okay, up to so on, the positive side, okay, the positive side. Now the 0 plus positive number is called the whole number. So from here to this side, okay, if I consider from 0 to positive side, all the number is called the whole number, and that representation is W, okay. So just we need to remember the representation here. The whole number representation is W, okay. Real number represented with R, okay. Rational number is Q, irrational number Q bar, okay. Fine. Integer we can represent, we represent with the I and Z. So these things actually sometime somewhere it's mentioned, okay. So if you remember, it will be better. So now in this video purely we will focus about the rational number, okay. So rational number, we know that, so any number that is the plus number or minus number, okay, or fractional number including zero, that can be represented in the P by Q form, okay. So we will discuss in detail the rational number in this chapter, okay. We will try to understand what is the rational number. Rational number is the any number that can be represented in the P by Q format, okay. So like P by Q, I mean to say P by Q format, if we can represent, okay, any number, that is called the rational number. But there is one condition, Q should not be 0. That means if you make the Q 0, the P by 0, P is any number by 0, it will be infinite, so that's not defined number. So that's why we say Q should not be 0, okay. So any number that can be formed in the P by Q, okay. So a
if I am saying p equal to 1, okay, and q equal to 1, okay, so what is the my rational number? 1 by 1 equal to 1. 1 is the rational number, okay. Now, if I take the example, okay, p equal to 2 and q equal to 4, okay, so what will be the p by q? It will be 2 by 4, it will be 1 by 2. This is also the rational number. Fine. If I take p equal to 5 and q equal to 1, so what will be the p by q? Will be 5 by 1 equal to 5. So 5 is the rational number. So we are seeing everywhere the q is not equal to 0. That we already taking care every time wherever I am mentioning the p by q. Okay. So if I say p by q, p is 10, okay, and q is 0. If I say p by q, okay, it will be 10 by 0. That's an undefined number, okay, that's infinite, we can't define this number. So that's why we say q should not be 0. So here this condition will not, we can't put it here, okay, we can't put it q equal to 0. Fine. So any two number, one is p and other is q, okay, we can represent, if we are able to represent p by q format, okay, that is called the rational number, okay. So it can be negative also, it can be positive also. If I say p equal to minus 7, okay, and q equal to minus 3, so what will be the p by q? It will be minus 7 by minus 3, it will be 7 by 3. This is the rational number, okay. Or if I take the example, p equal to minus 4, okay, q equal to 2, and what will be the, then p by q, it will be minus 4 by 2 minus 2. This is also the rational number, okay. So any number that can be represented to p by q is called the rational number. And square of the every number, like if I take the example p equal to root of 4, q equal to 1, then can we represent to p by q? So if I try to represent this number p by q format, it will be root 4 by 1, then 2 by 1 equal to 2, or we can say the plus minus, so plus minus 2. This is also the rational number. So any number, okay, if it is the square root, perfect square root, that is also called the rational number. So like, what are the operation we can perform on the rational number, like what are the property, okay. So if I say the sum of the two rational number is again the rational number, subtraction of the two rational number again the rational number, multiplication and division is also the same case, okay. So if I take the rational number, okay, 4 by 5 is the rational number. If I add, okay, 6 by 5 is again, this is also rational number, this is the rational number. So sum of these two rational number is, okay, this will be the 10 by 5 equal to 2. This is again the rational number, okay. This is, already I said the rational number, p by q format. This is also the rational number, okay. This is also, we can write 2 by 1. So that means sum of the two rational number or any rational number, okay, is again the rational number. Similar way, the subtraction, okay, so subtract from one rational number to the, subtract from the one rational number to the other rational number, again the number that we get it, that is also will be the rational number, okay. So if I take the same example, okay, or I will take here 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3, this is the rational number, this is the rational number that we are representing into the p by q, okay. What is the value here? 1 by 3. Again I am getting that this is the p by q format, okay, where q is not equal to 0, so that I can say this is also the rational number. Fine. And similar way, if I multiply two rational number, we will get the output as a rational number.
if I divide two or more rational number, that way if I say, if I divide two or more rational number, okay, again we will get the output as a rational number. If I take example, for example, okay, 2y3, this is a rational number. Second number I am taking 3y3, again one number I am taking 4y3, okay. I have taken here the three rational number. I am multiplying here, okay. What will be the value here? 8/9, okay. Or I can write here 24/27. So just divide with 3, okay, both sides. So you'll get the 8/9. That's why I have written here 8/9. Fine. So again, I am getting the number in the form of the p by q, where q is not there, 0. So q is 9 here, p is 8, okay. In this case, p is 8 and q is 9. So q is not equal to 0. So that means I can say this number is again the rational number, okay. Similar way, if I say, if I divide one rational number with the other rational number, I will get the output as a rational number. Okay. So if I say 2y3 divide with 3y6, okay. Now I can write this 2y3 into this, I will write in the reverse way. If I make this, okay, divide sign to multiply, this numerator and denominator will get changed. So 6y3. Earlier it was 3y6, so it will be 6y3 because I have changed them from the divide to multiplication. Or simply you can divide it, okay. So by 9, okay. Sorry, 4/3. So 4/3, again this is the p by q format, okay, and where q is not equal to 0, so I can say this number is again the rational number, okay. So this is the one property, okay. Few more properties, like if we reverse the rational number, if I have taken the rational number 2/3, okay, 2/3, if I reverse this, this is the rational number p by q, where q is not equal to 0, 3 is not equal to 0. If I reverse this, okay, just reverse this number, so it will be 3/2. This is again the rational number, okay, because here also the, this is the p by q format where q is not equal to 0. Now I will draw the number line, okay. This is my number line, this is 0, this is minus 1, this side, this is minus 2, this is minus 3, and this will go to the infinity, okay. Here it will be the plus 1, okay, plus 2, plus 3, okay, it will go up to infinity, okay. So this is my the rational number, okay. If I say, what is the number between these two? Okay. What is the number between 0 and 1? It can be 0.1. Again, if I go to the micro level, 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, up to 0.9, and this is 1. Okay. So how we can represent 0.1? Okay. If I have to represent 0.1 in the fraction, okay, I can write like 0.1, okay, divide by 10 and multiply by 10, it will be 1/10, okay. So now this is the, in terms of fraction, I can say 0.1 to 1/10. 0.1 equal to 1/10. 1/10 is the fractional format, okay. So these fractional format also, okay, come under the rational number. Fine. So here is few concept we will understand with this, okay. In terms of the fractional, some fractional number are terminating, some are non-terminating, okay, fine. So these concepts we will look in now. So some of the rational number are terminating, okay, after decimal point it will terminate after few numbers, okay. Some are the non-terminating, it will not terminate, okay, it will go up to, okay, infinite, it will not terminate, it will, the number will come, we can divide, okay, it will divide after decimal number, it will go up to infinity, okay. There is some non-terminal but recurring, so that such number is like
2.32456, again 456, something like that, okay? It's a recurring number will come. So this term will get repeat, it will go up to infinity, but this term will get repeat, okay? So this is called the non-terminating, it will not get terminated, non-terminating, but recurring number. This is called the recurring. So like the some set of the this number will come every time, okay? So this is called the this type of decimal number are called the non-terminating recurring number, okay? So there is some decimal is 3.5, okay? This is called the terminating, okay? Here is getting termination, okay? Some are called the decimal number is 3.56234625, okay, 62, it will go like this. So this is, we are not able to find out here the something recurring or repeating kind of number is coming. So that's a non-terminating decimal number, okay? So total three types of decimal number we have. One is the just terminating here. So after that, till here it's a division is over, okay? But here it's a non-terminating but recurring number will come, fine. So some constant number will come, but it will not terminate, it will go further, division will go and go, okay? The decimal number that is non-terminating and non-recurring, okay? So there is no recurring concept is there and non-terminating also. Now I will take the example of terminating number, non-terminating decimal number, okay? Terminating decimal number and non-terminating decimal recurring number, okay? So first I am taking the 1/3, okay? Or I can say 1/5, okay? This is the, if you divide 1 to the 5, okay, it will be 0.2, fine. After 0.2, nothing will come, okay? So this is called the terminating. So after 0.2, after 2, this division got terminated, okay? So this is called the terminating, okay, decimal number, fine. Now if I take the example of, okay, 1/3, okay, what will be? It will go up to so on, okay? So now here 3 is repeated every time, okay, but it's not terminating anywhere, it will go up to so on, okay, infinity, if it just divide, okay, fine. Or if I divide like this, okay, so it will become 9, okay, 1, again, so it will go up to so on, okay, that's the number I have written here, okay. So this is called the non-terminating recurring number. So this 3 is recurring every time. 3 is repeating. Recurring is nothing but the repeating every time. So 3 number is repeating every time, okay, after decimal. So this is called the non-terminating recurring number. Non-terminating, this division will not get terminated. It will go to the up to so on, okay, up to infinity. But it's a recurring. After decimal, this 3 is recurring, okay, it's a repeating. So that is called the non-terminating recurring number. Okay, if I take the example like 3/7, okay, what will be the number here? It will be 3/7, okay? So this is called the non-terminating, okay, decimal number. So now we will talk about the number line, okay? So if I say within 0 to 3, how many integer is there? 0, 1, 2, 3, okay? 0 to 1, how many integer is there? Okay? So 0 and 1 we can say integer, but within 0 and 1 there is no integer. So only the fraction will come, fine? So fraction is nothing but again the rational number, okay? Our other term, if I say, okay, what are the fraction will come here? 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, point up to 0.9, or we will go to the another micro label, okay,
it will come to 0.11, 0.12, 0.13, up to 0.19, okay, 0.99, then again 0.2, 0.21, 0.23, okay, something like that will come, okay. So if somebody will ask, ki 0 is the rational number, okay, 1 is the rational number, what are the other rational come within this, okay. So within 0 to 1, what are the other rational number come? We can say 0.1, 0.1 is nothing but them. We can say 1 by 10, okay? 1 by 20, 1 by 30, something like that. Or 1 by 2, okay? 1 by 3, 1 by 4. These are also the rational number because these are the one line between them, 0 to 1. Okay? 1 by 2 is nothing but the 0.5, okay? So 0.5 somewhere is the middle of the 0 and 1, okay? 1 by 3 is 0.33, so somewhere the 33% here it will lie. 0.1/3 of, okay, this line 0 to 1. 1/4 is 0.25% is 0.25, okay, so it will lie somewhere here. So these numbers is also lying between the 0 to 1 rational, okay, and 0 and 1 is the rational number, so we can say 1 by 2 within 0 and 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 8, all those are also the rational number, okay. So this kind of question will come, what are the rational number between 1 and 2? Give me 2 or 3 rational number between the 1 and 2. We can say like 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, 1 by 5, 1 by 6. Okay, these are the number. Okay, up to 1 by 9, these are the number. Are the rational number. Or we can go to the further micro level and we can say there is a lot of other rational number that can be represented in terms of the P by Q. Okay. But value should be P by Q, value should be, okay, if I say that within a 1 to 0, okay, what are the rational number, P by Q value should be within 0 and 1, okay, it can be 2 by 10 or 2 by 5, okay, so such number will also lying between the 0 and 1, those are also the rational number. So now we'll see some basic concept how to change from the decimal to fraction, okay, and fraction to decimal. So if I am saying 0.5, how to represent the fraction number? So 0.5, okay, that means for decimal, this point I can write, okay, first you write the 0.5, okay, for this decimal number, okay, it would be the 1, and what are the number is there, like 5 is the 1 number, so it would be 0, okay, just consider like, so first I will write the 0.5, I will remove the point here, okay, so I will write just 5, divide, okay, I have to write in the fraction. For the decimal, this I will put it 1, and the 1 number is there, only 5 is there here, so 1 0 will be there, okay, so this will be the 5 by 10, okay, this will be the 1 by 2. Okay, this is the fractional number for this decimal number. Like if I write the 0.54, I need to convert into the fractional number. Okay, so how to convert this into fractional number? These are the basic stuff I'm just telling. Okay, just I'll write without the decimal number in numerator 54. Okay, divide by, in place of point, I will put 1. Okay. And I have two number here, okay, after decimal I have two number, so 20 I will put it, okay, so 54/100 is the, okay, this is the decimal fractional representation of the 0.54 decimal representation, okay. If I take one example, okay, here 1/3, it will be 0.3, okay, so how to represent from the fractional to decimal, just divide 1 with 3, okay, so it will become like 0.33333, okay, fine. Now it's a repeating, okay, non-terminating decimal number, okay, non-terminating, okay, recurring number. So this is 0.33333 is recurring after point, okay, so that we can represent like 0.3 to the bar, okay, so bar is nothing but, so after this number is just recurring, 0.3 is recurring, okay, so 0.3 bar, okay, that bar,
3 bar means 3 is recurring multiple times, 0.3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, 3, this is meaning of 3 bar, okay.
So now I'll take one example, okay.
So if I say the 1 by 5 and, okay, 1 by 2, okay, this is the rational number, this is the rational number. What is the one rational number? Can I tell one more rational number between these two rational number?
Okay.
So if I see, okay, just if I see this expression, I can say like 1 by 5, okay, this is nothing but the 0.2. 1 by 2 is nothing but the 0.5, okay. If I draw the line, okay, this is 0.2, this is 0.1, okay. This is 0 somewhere, okay, minus 1, okay, this is 0.6 and this is 0.9 and this is the 1, okay, this is the 1 and this is the 2 and up to infinity, positive side it will go. Now I am talking about 1 by 5 is nothing but the 0.2, 1 by 2 is nothing but the 0.5, between any of the rational numbers, okay, I can get, can be infinite number of the rational number between 1 by 5 and 1 by 2. So 0.2 to 0.5, I can write any infinite number of the rational number is like, it can be 0.3 also, it can be 0.4 also, somewhere 0.3, somewhere 0.4. Like this 0.3 is nothing but the 3 by 10, 0.4 is nothing but the 4 by 10, these two are the rational number. So just I have to give the one rational number that I ask, so I can give anything, okay? Or it can be 0.31, 0.32, okay? It's an infinite number of the rational number. So we can draw the line number and we can give the, okay, rational number. But this is the easy one I have given, so it's easy to find out, okay, where it will lie and we can give the, okay, rational number. But there is approach like the rational number from, this is my base point, okay, so after 0.2 I have to give the rational number. So that means from 0.2, if I plus something, okay, plus any number, okay, 0.2 is the rational number, okay, fine. So 0.2 is the rational number, okay. So from 0.2, in 0.2, if I plus any rational number, any rational number, but that rational number should be less than 0.5, okay. I mean, so you sum up the, suppose this is the p by q, I am taking one rational number, okay. So these two sum should less than 0.5, okay, that number will be the one of the rational number between 0.2 to 0.5 or 1 by 5 to the and 1 by 2, okay. So what I can say, ki 0.2 plus p by q I am taking, okay. So p by q is nothing but, okay, p by q I am taking, okay, and that should be 0.5 minus 0.2, okay. So 0.5 minus 0.2 means 1 by 2 minus 1 by 5, so it will be 0.3, 3 by 10, okay. And p by q is nothing but the, within this, okay, 3 by 10, 3 by 10 is nothing but the this number, okay, 0.5 to 0.2, okay, this number is 3 by 10, 0.3, okay. So it can be 1 by 2 also, 1 by 4 also, something like that we can take it, okay. So 0.5 minus 0.2, so 1 by 2 minus, basically 1 by 2 minus 1 by 5 I have to do it, okay. So 10 is the LCM, 5 minus 2, 3 by 10 basically, yeah, 3 by 10 I have taken here. So it can be 1/4 also I can take it, 1/2 number, halfway I can take it, 1/4 I can take it, okay. 1/4, if I have to take it, it will go somewhere 1/4, 1/4, 1 by 2 if I take it, somewhere in the middle of these two numbers it will come, that rational number. So this is the concept to find out the rational number within a rational number, okay. So thank you very much. This is the all about the rational number. I will make one more video for the rational number, and I will go for the exercises in some other videos, okay.
So thank you very much. Please subscribe my channel.